back to the Man United fan stand. It was AZ nil, Manchester United nil. Seriously, enough is enough. Bloody hell. I mean, a nil-nil draw. I keep wanting to say 1-1 for some reason, but no, it's nil-nil. I wouldn't even want a bloody 1-1 draw. And look, I don't know if I've said this, but if we lose to Newcastle away or we draw, then I don't know. Should Ollie leave Manchester United? I don't believe he's getting sacked like 3 days before the bloody Newcastle match that we're playing them away. This match was away against AZ and we still can't bloody finish it off. Of course I'm annoyed. I just really just don't want to get too frustrated because it's just annoying. But seriously, these bloody players cannot be asked. The thing is, why sell Lukaku on deadline day? He could, look, he might have been able to do something by now. But no, we went on, we sold him on bloody deadline day. First of all, that's something stupid because I think we all knew that it was going to come down to something at a point. If Romelu Lukaku goes, it's going to turn into a complete nightmare up front. I didn't think we defended too bad today, but seriously, bloody hell, it's a complete nightmare up front. I mean, seriously, I've had it at Manchester United. Just going on playing like this, it's so poor. And seriously, we are Manchester United. I'm not sure if the players know what team they're playing for. I mean, I'm not proud whatsoever. It's just simply exactly like Park the Bus, just a little bit different. And I'm stuck. I don't know what to say about from that. Look, it's just so frustrating right now. It's such frustrating times to be a Manchester United fan right now. I mean, bloody hell, why can't we? I mean, it's as simple as that. Win away. Why can't we get a win away? And we can't, and also, we can't even get a decent win at home to start off with. West Ham, we lose 2-0 away. We're at home. We draw 1-0 to Arsenal when we could have easily won that. We go into this game. We play absolutely terribly. Yeah, we had about 10 minutes in that bloody first half that was ours. And we had about 3 to 5 minutes of the bloody second half, maybe 10. No, it's less than bloody 10 minutes. But I've had it, and I think a lot of Manchester United fans have. We know how frustrating this is right now to be a Manchester United fan. I mean, seriously, it's just absolutely ridiculous that we just can't do any simple things right now at Manchester United. And this is a big, extreme rant. Extreme rant which is going on here, because it's not good enough. The players have to play for whoever the manager is. It's not, if it's David Moyes, if it's Louis van Gaal, if it's Jose Mourinho, if it's Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, you have to play. And well, and we sat here this time last season thinking it's a complete mess. And we're here again thinking that, but it's in a more terrible position because we're sat here thinking and we're in the Europa League now. We were in the Europa League and I'm not even sure if we would have struggled this much in the Europa League under Jose Mourinho. We won the Europa League under Jose Mourinho. I don't even know. Oh, it's frustrating me. Jose Mourinho always has his third season syndrome. I don't know why I'm going on about this idiot though. But seriously, I don't know who's a better manager, Jose Mourinho or Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. I prefer Ole Gunnar Solskjaer a lot more than bloody Jose Mourinho. I can't stand Jose Mourinho. I can stand Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. I really do love Ole Gunnar Solskjaer as a player, as a manager. I just don't think his tactics work. And it's seriously frustrating. I want the players to play under him. I don't want to be saying Ole out. Maybe we should give him till the end of the season. But I don't believe it would work. I really don't. Is Ole going to get sacked at Christmas? I don't know. But seriously, some real, real, real bloody frustrating times right now at Manchester United is happening. And I feel like crying once again because I just can't stand it. I can't bloody stand what's going on right now at Manchester United. How's it nil-nil? Look, something has to be happening. The club have to be alert. I've had it right now, to be honest with you. I have actually bloody had enough. I've been pushed to the bloody limits right now. I really have. I really bloody have. So someone, please help us out. Please. We're Manchester United and we just can't get what we need. This isn't good enough, and every single Manchester United fan should know that. The players should know that. We all should know it's not good enough. And I bloody had it right now as a Manchester United fan, having to put up with watching this rubbish week in, week out. Ever since we've started this channel. Look, I've just witnessed playing boring football, and I just want to win some trophies right now at Manchester United, to be honest. It's just not working out. I mean, look, seriously, I just can't believe it. I remember when we won the Europa League under Jose Mourinho. It was amazing. 3 trophies in the season, the Carabao Cup, Community Shield. It was just amazing, to be honest with you. It's not as good as winning the treble. Unfortunately, I wasn't alive to see that. I was alive a bit when Sir Alex Ferguson was managing Manchester United. Obviously, I was younger then, so I didn't really watch football that much. But, you know, I'm just frustrated now. I mean, you know, I just don't know what to say, because it's just really frustrating, and I just find it, I'm sorry, I just find it hard to get my words out about this right now, to be honest with you. It's poor. We are bloody Manchester United, and the players do not play for this badge right here. I've still got a shirt saying Champions League. We're not in the Champions League. We're not Champions League quality. That's the thing. Our players should not play in the Champions League. And the reality is, no world-class player is going to want to come to Manchester United unless we get Champions League football. With the way we're playing, I can't bloody see us getting Champions League football. And the reality is, if we give only the rest of the season, I don't believe we're going to make it to Champions League football. We're going to struggle in the transfer window if we give only the rest of the season. If he's here in January, we're going to struggle in the transfer window. I don't even believe we're going to get that big signings in January, apart from a load of rubbish ones. I mean, not rubbish, but average signings. We're not an average side. We're meant to be Manchester United, the best, one of the best teams in the bloody world. But we're hardly one of the best teams in the world. We're not even in the bloody Champions League this season. And I've had it, to be honest, I've had it to bits. And seriously, anyone that tells me to relax, seriously, just rethink. I mean, if you're a Manchester United fan, you tell me to relax. If you tell any Manchester United fan to relax, whoever's doing your channel, I find you just ridiculous. Because how are you meant to relax if you play, if you just witness your team playing like that? Playing just rubbish football. It's ridiculous. It is bloody ridiculous, to be honest with you. And I've had it to bits. I have actually bloody had it. Something has to be happening right now if we're a Manchester United team. I mean, bloody hell. Is it that hard to try and be consistent? We're not clinical enough. We literally lost the ball in such dangerous areas where they can come and attack. Show me that there's more passion. Show every single one of us Manchester United fans that there is more passion. Sorry, I just got real sore throat. Seriously, it's just boring watching this side play. It's bloody boring. And seriously, something has to change. We are Manchester United. I saw literally nothing of our players today. There was nothing to be seen. Actually bloody nothing. Just someone name me something good that I saw today. We had one chance with Greenwood. Apart from that, I mean, and then it was blocked. Did we even have a bloody proper shot on goal? No, we bloody didn't have a bloody shot. I was watching the whole bloody thing. We barely had a shot. I mean, yeah, it was quite promising, like the first 10 minutes or so. But where we barely got a decent threatening shot on goal to even try and test the bloody goalkeeper. No, we didn't. No, we did not get a decent shot on goal. Someone name me something good that you saw. Someone name me a player that played well. David De Gea played well. I'm not allowing any other player. Anyone that says any other player played well. I mean, there might have been. But overall, I mean, I didn't think we played too bad in defence. I said it. But is it, or is it because David De Gea was saving us the whole bloody time? Maybe that's why. That's probably the answer of everyone's questions. That's why apparently we played well at the back. I don't know, but I'm confused. I am generally a bit confused right now, to be honest with you. Really confused. And right now I've actually had it, to be honest with you. I have bloody had it. We're meant to be Manchester United and... And we're just there wanting, and the players are just there giving us that rubbish. Why? I just don't understand. I just don't understand what's going on right now at Manchester United, to be honest with you, but it is generally just really, really frustrating, to be honest with you. It is frustrating, right now to be a Manchester United fan. And yeah, it's just not working whatsoever, to be honest. It's just not, none of the tactics just really working out right at this moment in time. And yeah, it's just simply not good enough. I'm disappointed, obviously, really angry, really frustrated. And yeah, it's just not working. It's just seriously just not working right now at Manchester United. I mean, seriously, look, we should have won that game. I mean, it's not like we had chances. If there was VAR, they probably would have won that game because of penalties. I mean, look, we could have got one penalty in that game. But seriously, I'm not even sure if there is VAR in the Europa League. I'm really not sure, but it's really frustrating right now at Manchester United. To be witnessing all this rubbish, to be honest with you. So, yeah. Anyway, I'm gonna be ending this video here.